Hey everybody, before we get started with the video, I just wanted to apologize real quick because the audio is not quite as good as it should be, mostly because somebody decided to ride up alongside of us on a mini bike right when we started the interview, and that definitely didn't help matters. But Jim was a really fun and interesting guy to talk to, so I really wanted to put this video together anyway. Jim has your typical hot rods and muscle cars at home as well, but now that he's retired, he decided just to build cars that he finds fun. And in this video, you'll see a couple of those. He's always got new projects coming along. You know, he's putting Hemis and 440s into really unusual cars. And it's just kind of cool to see somebody doing what they have fun doing and building really unique stuff. Like he says, most of his cars either have a real engine in the back and a fake one in the front, or a real engine in the front and a fake one in the back. But either way, it's always something really unique. And I'm probably going to catch up with him later and see some of his other projects as well, because it's just some pretty cool and interesting stuff. But anyway, hopefully you guys enjoy them. Thanks for watching, and we'll get on with it here. Hey everybody, coming to you from Gateway Motorsports Park over here at Mega Mopar Weekend. And I was walking around the car show and swap meet, and I came across something really unusual. Definitely a one-of-a-kind car. And we have the owner here, so I thought I'd let him tell us what's going on here and what this is exactly. And what's your name, first of all?
My name is Jim Pagel from St. Louis, Missouri.
And what do we have here, Jim?
This is a 1988 Jaguar XJS coupe that's had a few modifications. One of them is a 440 with a Chrysler long ram engine in the rear.
Wow.
Transmission in the back seat. 55 Jeep 4x4 front axle. It's got a 63 Studebaker truck grill.
Oh, wow.
Homemade bumper.
Mm-hmm.
And we used this same format years ago for Halloween and parked it in the yard.
Oh, okay.
And around the back, this is a grill out of a 76 Ramblin.
Oh, yeah. The AMC, the X Gremlin. That's pretty cool.
Right. This is a Jaguar bumper with the cover off of it.
Okay.
The front suspension of the Jaguar was moved to the back.
Okay.
And the center was cut out of it and made into a hardtail. It has no shockers on it.
Oh, okay.
And what you see is what you get. This is actually had a gas fill door here, but we took it off and I put a convertible fill because they're on the outside.
I see.
And you can look in here, and here's.
Oh, okay. Oh, I see. And then we can see the transmission there.
Coupled together.
That's Torque Flight.
Torque Flight 727.
Okay.
And the intake manifolds come off of a 1960 Chrysler 413.
Oh, all right. Big Max wedge. That's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'd be off like a Golden Lion or something like
yes.
that back then. Yeah.
Yes.
That's a really interesting setup. How long did it take you to put this together?
You know, off and on and with weather conditions and stuff, we worked on it off and on about 9.5 months.
Oh, really?
Okay. And actually finished it up this morning.
Mm-hmm. It definitely caught my eye. I mean, it's one of a kind for sure. I was trying to figure out exactly what it was, you know? Pretty interesting. And pretty good set of rubber you got on the back of there, too.
Mm-hmm. This is the center of a Jaguar bumper.
Okay.
Just taken out because it come in pieces.
That is pretty wild. Did you just have like a bunch of different cars sitting around? And you thought, well, we'll see if we can.
I got 11 cars.
Oh, okay.
In their various AMCs,
mm-hmm.
Javelins, Challenger convertible,
mm-hmm.
51 Plymouth with a Hemi in it.
Oh, really?
1954 Sunbeam.
Oh, cool.
The long ram stuff on it.
Oh, really? Wow.
Cool.
Yeah, but man, this really caught my eye. But hey, I really appreciate you talking about it a little bit. And you know, like I said, it's just one of those things. It's just cool to find something totally unique that that you put together. Well, I like seeing stuff like that.
Last year, I built a 88 Jaguar convertible,
mm-hmm.
and threw the top away.
All right, guys. So as you can see, Jim built some pretty unique stuff there. And like I said, hopefully I'll catch up with him in the future and see some of his other projects. I know he has something going on right now, either with an AMX or a Javelin, I can't recall. But he's doing something pretty crazy with the motor. And I don't want to give it away yet. But hopefully I'll get a look at that car because it's going to be pretty interesting. But hopefully you guys liked it. Thanks for watching and commenting and everything. And I'll see you later. Bye.